I know a song that gets on everybody's nerves, and this is how it goes.
You know, one of the age-old questions is how to write an energized theme song about a lazy character. The answer is, not this. Anything but this. We'll return to Seinfeld after your regularly scheduled terrible theme song. So, what's so bad about this one? I mean, beyond the music being lazier than Garfield himself. Well, the tempo. Just listen to how slow this song is. It goes on for a minute, but by God, it feels like you've just sat through a full 22-minute episode by the time that it's done. And then it gets worse. This theme song has dozens of obnoxious sound effects. All of them are above the singing. I don't get why even the worst theme songs do this, put the singing under the music track, or have obnoxious sound effects over it. And when you can hear the singing, this is the guy's flow. The singer, he sounds out of breath. It sounds like the beat is outrunning him. Like, he's singing on a teleprompter that's just throwing up words too fast for him to keep up. I think we all do, sir. It's kind of what Garfield is known for. And they say it twice like it's the most impressive feature about Garfield. Or the most impressive feature about the singer is that he knows that Garfield is a cat. And at the end, the song just kind of gives up and starts throwing up random lyrics. Considering that this theme song is unique to season 7 of the show, it makes you wonder why they didn't just stick to the earlier theme songs. It definitely answers the question as to why that this was the last season of the show. We have to move on. If I try listening to this theme song any longer, I'd fall asleep. Good thing our next song is quite the wake-up call.
I know a song that gets on everybody's nerves, and this is how it goes. Buckle up, duckies, cause we got a rocket
band. Delivering bread, flying crazy cause we can. You knew it. You knew that this one had to make the list. Cause we can. Crazy, crazy, crazy cause we can. Get it? It kinda sounds like crazy, but it's not, because we made our own slang that not even kids think are cool. Fuck you! Get it? We made a reference from a video game that's 19 years old when our audience is like 7. Fuck you! Get it? We've got asses! Fuck you! This song makes me want to take a Badoose. This theme song is actually relatively short, but my God, it beats down on you with how in your face it is. But believe it or not, I don't think the music itself gets enough hate. Whose idea was it to have a fucking xylophone as the dominant instrument? Like, what part of the show does it make you just think, yes, xylophone? At some point, the music just stops. Not to give emphasis to any words like competent people would do, but to some random monsters chomping, because they totally have a lot of relevance to the show. At some point, it sounds like they broke an arcade machine. You know, breadwinners, did you ever think that it might be a good idea to have a cartoon about video games if you want to reference them every 5 seconds? Yeah, I get it, video games are popular, but it's like if you were to, I don't know, referencing the Titanic every 5 seconds. Actually, no, this show has more in common with the Titanic than it does with video games, fuck you!
I know a song that gets on everybody's nerves, and this is how it goes.
So, apparently this show is about a ronin during a period of war, and from the animation itself, it looks like the show is really action-packed. So who's the perfect singer for this theme song? A 7-year-old girl, why not? judging by the music of this theme song, it seems that this show is a slice of life schoolgirl romance. And according to the animation, that's the furthest thing from it. This is the most mismatched visuals that I've ever seen. I could combine random theme song animation from other cartoons with random songs from my computer's library, and any of them would fit better. Don't believe me? Just watch! That last one fit way too well to be a coincidence. And it's probably just a coincidence. Also, for some reason, this campy pop singing is on top of a bluegrass theme that starts out really harsh for some reason. Almost like the opening to Street Sharks. Then it goes, "Surprise! Poppy love song!" Whoever the hell is singing really can't. It's especially noticeable in the long and high notes. This gets really painful at the end. I don't want to beat down on the lyrics, since it's probably a mistranslation or something, but when you have lines like this, I have to say something. I'd be so happy inside my heart. You know, I'd prefer to be happy in reality. And sometimes that involves fast food, which doesn't make me happy inside my heart, believe me. As opposed to being beautiful in reality. Are you misremembering some traumatic event from your past? I mean, the theme song for this action show reminds me of the song "I Want a Hippopotamus for Christmas." Worst dubbing theme of all time. It's an action show with a cutesy singer who can't sing over a harsh bluegrass theme about what sounds like a schoolgirl falling in love. I'm sure that the anime is really good, which, in all respects, makes this theme song even more tragic.
I know a song that gets on everybody's nerves, and this is how it goes.
My name is Angela, hey hello, welcome to my very own show.
Speaking of little girls that can't sing a goddamn note, we need a theme song, but we don't have any money, effort, or time to hire an actual singer. Hell, we barely had enough of that to make a show. How about we use the voice actress?
Shooby-dooby-doo-wah-wah, my name is Angela, and you are not—
Wait, what do you mean you can't sing? Don't worry about it. It doesn't really matter. Talent and skill? Those things are fucking optional. Have you heard the Hammerman theme? Talent and effort wouldn't help you anyway. You know what? I think we could save even more money on this. Hey, does the song need a songwriter? No, okay, thanks. This song sucks. This song sucks, it sucks, it sucks. Okay, who are they? Oh wait, you're not gonna tell me. So, you're not going to introduce your friends to me, even though you just said you would do so.
My name is Angela, hey hello. Welcome to my Marion show.
Okay, but who are you? And why should I care about your show?
You see, if we're going to watch your theme show based on who you are, we're going to need some insight into exactly who you are and why we should be watching a show that stars you.
Danny Fenton, he was just 14 when his parents built a very strange machine. It was a great big dash of things to change. His molecules got all rearranged. When he first woke up, he realized he had snow white hair and glowing green eyes. He could walk through walls, disappear, and fly.
Gonna get a little weird, gonna get a little wild. I ain't from around here, I'm from another dimension.
My name is Angela, hey hello. Welcome to my Marion show.
Not only is it basic theme song 101, it's also basic fucking logic.
Oh no, it's Minnie Pooh.
Okay, so the only character we get any details about is apparently, Okay then, I have no idea what you just said.
And now to today's story, starring me, and not starring Nanette Manwar.
If she's not in the story, then why the hell did you introduce her? Everything about this theme song is some of the most incompetent everything. The singing gets a lot of hate, and while it is some of the worst.
Introduce my friends to you. Oh no, it's Minnie Pooh.
My god, did you record this after a tonsillitis surgery? I really, really hate the lyrics. I don't want to say that this is the worst written theme song of all time, because we've still got 5 songs to go, but it's definitely one of the laziest. Hey, we need a theme song, so let's see what we can put together in 5 minutes. Nothing about this is redeemable in any sense of the word. And god, that high note at the end, it's enough to break glass.
And now, to today's story, starring me.
I know a song that gets on everybody's nerves, and this is how it goes.
Hey, would you look at that? We got another tie, and hopefully the last one on the list. I can't show you footage from either of these shows, because Nickelodeon has done a good job of scrubbing them from the internet. As much as I'd love to complain, considering what these shows are, that's probably for the best. And at least I have the soundtracks of them.
Here we go, good for bad boy, jump, jump. A little cute, cute, bad boy, jump, jump. You're amazing, totally crazy, bad boy, jump, jump. Come on, everybody sing!
Rock shoes like feetsies, you are watching Planet Sheensies.
Okay, not called Planet Sheensies.
Ladies and gentlemen, Fanboy and Chum Chum and Planet Sheen. Fanboy and Chum Chum starts with what sounds like a campfire whistle, trying to trick you that you might actually be watching a good show like Camp Lazlo. And then it pounces the surprise on you. Everything about this theme song is some of the purest crap that you will ever find. It feels like the music is literally punching me. But what I hate, what I absolutely fucking hate, is the singing. Yes, let's sing in the most scratchy voice we possibly can. I could sing better than this, with a cold. Then at the end it delves into this. Yeah, totally makes me want to watch your show. Honestly, you should probably be thankful that I'm not showing you the animation. Trust me, it's just bizarre as fuck. Honestly, if I didn't know any better, I'd blame the entirety of the ADHD epidemic on this show.
Oh, that's nice.
No. Planet Sheen is, get this, another fucking rap number.
Planet Sheen is oh so funky. Skateboards rock, shoes like feetsies. You are watching Planet Sheensy.
But I don't think I need to criticize this one because Sheen actually does a good job for me.
Yeah, I get the last part, but the first two lines, you're just off, bro. Not called Planet Sheensy.
I know what they're trying to do. They're trying to make Sheen seem you know, cool in comparison. He knows that this sucks, but the problem is that they also made Sheen one of the dumbest characters in Nickelodeon history, which is quite the accomplishment, by the way. And if even Sheen knows that this theme song is terrible, well, I think that you fucked up. Other than that, there's the ending, where there's this breakdown that makes no sense at all. God damn, both of these shows were some of the biggest mistakes just in history.
I'm surrounded by idiots.
I know a song that gets on everybody's nerves, and this is how it goes.
You know, I think I can let this one speak for itself. So, terrible theme song. What's number 5 on this list?
It's the Nutshack.
Yeah, if Kirby Right Back At Ya is the god of themes that just shout whatever the hell it is, expecting you to get what it's about, well, Nutshack is the rest of the fucking pantheon. I have no idea what the fuck a Nutshack is, and I don't think that I want to know. For half of this song, they just drone on this one line. On and on. The theme song never explains what the Nutshack actually is. So I'm going to assume that this is about a snack bar on a beach somewhere that sells all kinds of nutty snacks like peanut butter bars. I mean, we could probably use the animation to help figure out what the hell the Nutshack is. It seems to have an uncomfortable fascination with genitals, so I am going to assume that the Nutshack is a film studio responsible for sleazy, terrible pornographic films. Also, I said that this is shouted for only half of the theme song. No one ever seems to talk about the other half, because, well... Hey! Hey, speak up! I can't hear you over your obnoxious beats. I've listened to this theme song so many times. Like, I doubled down on how many times I listened to this theme song compared to all of the others. And I've never been able to make out all of the lyrics. Except for, you know, this. But let me try. I have no idea what either of those things mean. Okay then. He wears feel and loves the ladies. What the fuck is feel? Do you mean felt? Does he wear felt? I don't know. One of the most shallow assholes care about that kind of shit. Then again, I'm pretty sure that's the target demographic of the show. What? Okay, that kind of sounds like voodoo chants or some shit. Oh, fuck you! What? Grapes? Okay, so according to Urban Dictionary, grapes is slang for marijuana. Could you, I don't know, fucking care? Honestly though, that probably explains why this song is constantly slurring and is fucking beneath the beat. They just don't care about what the hell they're saying. Let's just move on before this song makes me shake it like a seizure, because it's about to give me a seizure.
It's the Nutshack. It's the Nutshack. It's the Nutshack.
I know a song that gets on everybody's nerves, and this is how it goes.
You know, with all these bad themes, I really think we might need to listen to a good theme song. You know, to take a break. There are so many good choices to choose from. Let's see, there's the Powerpuff Girls, that's a good one. DuckTales is great. Ooh, the Arthur theme, that's always fun. Oh, I know. Let's take a look at the Captain Planet theme.
I am Captain Planet.
Captain Planet. He's our hero. Gonna take pollution down to zero. He's our powers magnified. And he's fighting on the planet side.
It's a little cheesy, but you gotta admit that it just sounds awesome. Unless, of course, we're talking about the season 6 theme.
Captain Planet. the man, leading the Chargers' number one fan. Check him out, you're gonna see. He's the Mega Mac Daddy of ecology.
What the fuck? No, I'm serious. What the actual fuck? This is a parody, right? Did someone on the internet make this 20 years later? No. It's actually fucking real. Look, the original ending theme to Captain Planet. If I included ending themes on my admirable list, despite the song's corniness, it could have easily made it. What the hell happened?
I'm back! But when eco villains run amok, plundering and pillaging, yuck, have to reach a level of playing field with a PhD in sustainable yield. But he's not the only hero for Earth. Guys, wisdom gave the Planeteers birth.
I'll tell you what happened. Captain Planet sold out! Do these marketing hacks really think that all you need to do to sell your product is to be rad and hip?
Now you're gonna see, he's the Mega Mac Daddy of ecology. Captain the hero with the gumption, take on the overpopulation and consumption.
It sounds absolutely ridiculous. If I had someone like that, do you think that would make me seem appealing? Shit, is this thing gonna go poltergeist on me? If it is, I'm fucking out of here. The rapping is so fucking forced. Like, ow, it literally hurts my brain trying to comprehend how they thought that any of this sounded good to anyone.
Wheeler's the fire, but he's got heart. He's got the power to make water spark. Swami's rocking with element Earth, and Lika uses wind for all she's worth.
And what the hell is with these yellow gremlin lips? They look fucking terrifying.
Mega Mac Daddy of ecology. Hero with the gumption, take on the overpopulation and consumption. Yeah.
I love that they use the wah-wah trumpet for the instrument behind this.
Yeah, you can use a better groomer.
Some people say he's got a bad sense of humor.
Everyone says that. Everyone says that Captain Planet's jokes are just the corniest. And wait, aren't you trying to make him seem great? Yeah, good compliments, buddy.
No villain, run amok, plundering and pillaging.
Oh, that's a clever rhyme. Your rhythm amazes me.
Raise your voice and challenge your peers.
Hey, Jimmy, you want to do a cigarette? No. Some floating yellow lips trying way too hard to be cool told me not to. Oh, fuck, then we gotta listen to him. Actually, no, George, beat him up. Oh, great, the dude is slurring now. Okay, the rapping is forced and the singing is fucking awful. But what about the music itself, besides the weird wah-wah trumpet? Listen to this. I thought that Breadwinners was bizarre for using a xylophone, but this is using a Morse code machine. What the hell? Are you sending me an SOS message? Honestly, that would explain a few things.
Check him out, you're gonna see. He's the Mega Mac Daddy of ecology.
Wait, what?
He's the Mega Mac Daddy of ecology.
You know what? Take your ring back and fuck off!
I know a song that gets on everybody's nerves, and this is how it goes.
No thanks. I think I'll take the lobotomy instead. It'd do less damage to my life, my future, and my overall state of well-being. I mean, just listening to this theme song leaves my mouth agape in awe. How does anyone accept a product like this? Never mind an audience, how does a producer or anyone behind the show think that this is a good idea? It's like they intentionally made the theme song as annoying as possible. Who the hell signed off on this? It's just the word flub farted over and over again, with someone screaming in the background while being kicked in the stomach. I've heard more auditorily pleasing fist fights. You only make this kind of theme song when you want your show to fail. And apparently, that plan succeeded. As it was very hard for me to find any clips from this show, that's what's up with the watermark. Even the animation that we see is pure unadulterated nonsense. Do you have any of the vaguest idea what the show is about? From the, let's call it music? Or, I don't know, the animation? I have no idea. This theme song is a mystery. Like, it's beyond our mortal comprehension. I don't know what to say about this one. I'm sorry. And that was my top 20 worst theme... Wait, what? What do you mean there's two more? Two! We found two theme songs worse than a power drill going off in someone's throat. Isn't that, like, mathematically impossible? Are you sure we're not gonna make a black hole doing this? I think I could cry.
The audience is now deaf. I know a song that gets on everybody's nerves, and this is how it goes.
Some theme songs are made, others are shat out.
So, this is the bottom of the barrel of try-hard rap themes. Actually, I wouldn't call it a rap because there are like three different styles, all sewn together ass to end. The first sentence tries to trick you into thinking that this might be something interesting, cool, or dare I say, watchable. Then we get into the rap. Now, I really went to town on this theme, in particular in my review, but this one is so terrible, there's always more to say. First of all, what the fuck did you do to your voice? How the hell do you make your voice sound like this? It legitimately sounds like you shoved a cactus down your throat. Coincidentally, your singing makes me feel like I'm jamming a cactus in my ears. Oh good, you have some self-awareness. Wait, how the fuck does anyone expect you to say any of this stupid shit? The show is called Kung Fu? Sorry, I couldn't finish saying it myself. Call myself heaving because this theme song makes me physically sick. By the way, it's pronounced pterodactyl. It's about as difficult as triceratops. Also, technically pterodactyls are not dinosaurs, so he shouldn't even be in this show. And then at the end we get to this weird, like, space opera. And a kung fu show about dinosaurs. But it's hard to sound epic when you're talking about kung. I'll be right back. I gotta throw up.
I know a song that gets on everybody's nerves, and this is how it goes.
I like this show quite a bit, but the season one theme song sounds like someone threw a copy of Jet Set Radio in the washing machine. This theme song is the most blatant plagiarism that I've ever heard. But that being said, Green Day's American Idiot sounds great. And at least, this song retains some of the original's qualities. And not to mention, Johnny Test really is a fucking idiot.
You want a puppy to love, a new best friend from above.
Okay, so whenever I hear this song, it makes me think that the singer has like this demented smile that keeps getting bigger and bigger as the song goes on, while people are being mauled by dogs in the background. Is that just me? So, this theme song is basically what happens when you try to fart Beethoven. I've got plenty of problems with the farting, but it still roughly sounds like Beethoven. I was really tempted to put this on the list, but I decided to keep it off because, honestly, its biggest crime is that it's a bluegrass theme for a show they could use rock, metal, rap, fucking anything but bluegrass. Guys, he's fucking RoboCop. RoboCop. It's fucking RoboCop.
Back and chill for a while. I'm coming at ya like Tomb Style. So get ready for a funny bone overload. Yo, the little shop posse is gaining respect. So break out before I put you in jail.
God. What are you smoking? I honestly don't think this theme song is too bad. Don't get me wrong, the lyrics are fucking horrible, but the music, it actually sounds awesome. Minus the quacking at the end. This theme song is so hilariously pathetic.
I know a song that gets on everybody's nerves. Everybody's nerves, yes, on everybody's nerves. I know a song that gets on everybody's nerves, and this is how it goes.
Oh, Shaggy,
You might remember me saying this in my top 10 worst cartoons of the 2000 list.
That's just about the worst theme song I've ever heard in my life.
You know what? That hasn't changed. Everything about this song is the worst. The music is the worst. It sounds like it's been thrown in a meat grinder, and I have no idea why the music should suck so horribly, because the song is a blatant ripoff of Offspring's One Fine Day. Exactly the same, except this one sounds like shit.
I'll steal it! No one will ever know!
You'll notice the singing in the real song doesn't make you want to slice your ears off to stop the pain. I'd say there's no effort in the singing, but oh my fucking god, you've really got to try to sing this bad. I've heard some truly horrible music. But honestly, I'd rather listen to Fergie's London Bridge than this shit. It drones on and on, repeating the same lines over and over again. Speaking of that, what are the actual lyrics? We're on the road again with Jelly to the End. Learn to enunciate! And again, this is Shaggy and Scooby that we're talking about. So this show is about Shaggy and Scooby-Doo watching cartoons. Riveting. Also, what the fuck is up with the typewriter dance? Is this what I'm doing right now while I type this script? Am I dancing? Is this a legit type of dance? Can I go down to a club and just start randomly typing midair? No shit. How does anyone eat food for someone else?
Like, you know what this is supposed to mean, man. Like, we eat food, but we don't do it for you. Like, we do eating commissions, though, man. Like, $50 for us to eat for you, $100 to film it. It's a weird sexual thing that we're trying to make a profit off, man. But, like, if we're really successful, we can make it a really good business. Isn't that right, Scoob?
Please, Jackie, I can't handle this anymore.
Oh, shut up, Scoob, and eat your Scooby snack.
No, no,
like,
no,
just open up, Scooby, and eat your fucking Scooby snack!
And then there's this. Sorry, whoever the fuck sang this, but that goes against the Geneva Convention. So if you do that, I'm going to have you executed for crimes of war. Well, you asked for it. Goodbye, everybody.
Tactical nuke incoming!
Sometimes it's hard to know which way you're supposed to go, but deep inside, you know you're